Welcome to the Open Heavens Devotional of the Redeemed Christian Church of God, Oklahoma City. The Open Heavens Daily Devotional is written by our Father in the Lord, the General Overseer of the Redeemed Christian Church of God, Pastor E.A. Adeboye. Today, the 21st day of March, we'll be concluding the series we started a couple of days ago, The Fire. The topic of this morning's devotional is The Fire Part 3. I believe today and in your life, and henceforth, that the fire of the Almighty God will perpetually fall and remain with you in the name of Jesus. That you are born for God and that you will be potent for Him in the name. Your light will shine forth in the name of Jesus. Before we go into God's word this morning, I want us to just say a word of prayer. Father, Lord, we thank you again for another opportunity you've given unto us to see a brand new day. That God, as we are going into your word, that your word will transform our life. Your word will transform our world in the name of Jesus. That God will pray every alignment, everything that needs to be changed, that God will open our eyes to make appropriate amends in the name of Jesus. That we will not just be the hearer of your word, but will be a doer of your word in the name of Jesus. Thank you, Lord, for in Jesus' name we have prayed. Amen. The Fire Part 3. A memory verse is taken from the book of Luke chapter 3, verse 16. Luke chapter 3, verse 16. Reads, and I quote, John answered, saying unto them all, I indeed baptize you with water, but one mightier than I cometh, the latchet of whose shoes I am not worthy to unloose, he shall baptize you with the Holy Ghost and with fire. God will baptize you. The Almighty will baptize you with fire and the Holy Ghost. And when you are baptized with the fire and the Holy Ghost, what happens? The heavens will open over your head and you will do the impossible. The things that appear impossible to you will be possible to you in the name of Jesus. God will give you the wisdom. He will transform you and He will make you able to achieve, and He'll give you acceleration, He'll give you speed to do what seemed to be impossible. In 1 Kings chapter 18, verse 38, the fire consumed the water. In this context, water represents tears and sorrow. Whatever might be the source of tears, whatever might be the source of sorrow in your life, the Holy Spirit, the fire of the Almighty God, will fall upon you and it will transform your situation. It will give you insight, it will give you wisdom, and it will give you power to overcome those stumbling blocks and to overcome those challenges, and it will wipe away your sorrows in the name of Jesus. The Holy Spirit is the comforter who licks up your tears and gives you comfort, just like Jesus Christ said that when I'm going, and I'm not leaving you, but I'm sending you a comfort. I'm sending you someone who will help you. It will be your guide. It will be your comforter. And as we align ourselves with Him, the Holy Spirit will comfort you. Whatever challenge you're going through, whatever difficulty, it will comfort you and He'll help you navigate through. It will be your help. It will sustain you. It will be your guide. It will direct you in the name of Jesus. For all those tears you shed at night behind closed doors, God sees you. And He will send His Holy Spirit to comfort you in the name of Jesus. Note that Elijah had purposely asked that water be poured on the sacrifice. There are certain sorrows that are self-caused. There are certain things that are self-inflicted. The Holy Spirit will comfort you in the name of Jesus. The Holy Spirit comforts us in such also, according to John chapter 4, verse 18. That is why I have good news for anyone who have made several mistakes in your path. Your mistakes will not define you. For God will transform you. He will bring you out of that mess. He will transform that mess. And He will turn those messes to become a message. That you will say, truly, I can see the hand of God in my life in the name of Jesus. Those trials that God will transform and will turn those trials into triumph in the name of Jesus. Whatever test you are going through, God will turn it and will turn your test into testimony in the name of Jesus. That is why I have a good news for everyone who has made several mistakes in the past. The Holy Spirit will wipe your tears and give you a fresh start. In the mighty name of Jesus. The fire also consumed the dust. Humans are made out of dust. The dust represents human flesh. One of the names of the Holy Spirit is that He is a transformer, as we see in 1 Kings chapter 18, verse 48, verse 46. And the fire of the Lord was on Elijah, and he gathered up his loins and ran before Ahab to the entrance of Jezreel. When the hand of God, another name of the Holy Spirit, came upon Elijah, he became stronger and faster than the chariots drawn by horses. He was transformed. Just like he was transformed and he was able to launch out and he ran before air. God is saying that he wants to give you divine speed. He wants to give you divine acceleration. He wants to give you divine promotion. But we need to open up unto that. God, give me that empowerment to be able to run and overtake whatever it is that it seems as if my hands have not been able to reach, and it seems as if I'm being drawn back. God wants to give you divine speed, and you will be able to overcome those situations. And God will turn your troubles and into triumph in the name of Jesus. And he will give you double for your trials, and for you give you double for everything you've actually lost in the name of Jesus. He will transform you. You see, Samson had, when he was fighting, when he was about to fight the Philistine, he actually fought them with the jaws of he fought them with the jawbone, but God transformed that jawbone. In his hand, it was a jawbone, but God used that jawbone as a mighty instrument. When David was about to fight Goliath, Goliath seemed to be that Goliath appears to be the impossible obstacle in front of the children of Israel. He was terrifying, but when David came and gave it, crying up and actually depending on God, God used that stone in his hand, and God actually used and navigated and used that stone with as small as it was, God actually used that stone to actually bring down the giant, the Goliath that was actually facing the children of Israel. So whatever it is that seems to be little in your hand, once you just open up unto God, God will use it. He will transform those things to become a potent weapon in his hand, and he will bring down that obstacle. He will bring down that trouble. He will bring down that challenge for you in the name of Jesus. He was transformed in Judges chapter 15 from verse 14 to 15. We see the Holy Spirit transformed the jawbone of an ass into a weapon of warfare. In Romans chapter 8 verse 11, he says, "But if the spirit of him that raised up Jesus from the dead dwells in you, he that raised up Christ from the dead shall also quicken your mortal bodies by his spirit that dwelleth in you." Whatever it is that is dead, whatever it is that is dead in your life, God will quicken it in the name of Jesus. The same spirit that rose Christ from the dead, it dwells in you, and it will quicken your mortal body in the name of Jesus. Are you going through a health challenge? God will quicken your mortal body. He will restore your health. Are you going through a financial situation? God will grant you favor and he will turn around your finances. Are you going through a career difficulty? God will transform it and God will give you breakthrough in the name of Jesus. When the fire of the Holy Spirit comes on you, you no longer live by the flesh but by the Spirit. The moment you are baptized by the Holy Spirit, Holy Ghost and fire, you become transformed. May you experience the transforming fire of the Holy Ghost in the mighty name of Jesus. I decree over the life of everyone listening to me that the transforming power, the transforming fire of the Almighty God will dwell upon you, and it will transform that situation, that hopeless situation. It will transform it and give you hope in the name of Jesus. It will transform that situation and give you breakthrough. You will break through, you will break forth in the name of Jesus. Henceforth, the direction you will be moving will be upwards and forwards in the name of Jesus. So the action point today is this: make time to pray in the Holy Ghost for at least one day. Make time to pray in the Holy Ghost. And as you begin to spend time and pray in the Holy Ghost, that God will descend upon you. Just like he has said that the disciples should tarry in Jerusalem till they be endued with power from on high. So as we make that commitment, may you also be endued with power from on high to be able to carry out the impossibility, for you to be able to carry out the assignments that seem to be impossible, and for you to be able to transform your world. And this shall be your testimony in the name of Jesus. Let's say a word of prayer. Father Lord, we thank you for your word. We thank you for how you minister unto us today. We know that you have greater plans for us, and you want to keep us to do the impossible. You want to keep us to be able to overcome life challenges, to be able to overcome the situations ahead of us. For we know we can do nothing except by you. That God, as we are making that commitment to spend time in your presence, to pray and develop an intimate relationship with you, we'll pray over the life of everyone listening, that God, your power will rest and dwell upon us in the name of Jesus. Thank you, Lord, for in Jesus' name we have prayed. Amen. I hope you are blessed by today's devotional. I look forward to seeing you tomorrow. Have a blessed day.